Hello everyone. If you are interested to apply for a job seeker visa to Portugal, then this video is for you. But before that, I'd like to share with you how me and my friend Tina come up with this visa. So in mid last year, around July 2023, me and Tina were exploring options to travel to Europe for work that would lead to permanent residency or citizenship. We came across various options such as the Golden Visa and the Digital Nomad Visa offered by different European countries. The Golden Visa allows a foreigner to stay in the country for investment purposes or if they can prove passive income such as pension, income from rent, or income from creating a content like YouTubers. On the other hand, the Digital Nomad Visa allows a foreigner to live and work in the country as long as they can prove that they can perform their job remotely, such as social media manager, virtual assistants, and the like. The Golden Visa isn't suitable for us, but the Digital Nomad Visa would work as I am a recruiter and my friend is an accountant and we both work remotely. All we have to do is to secure a document to prove it, such as a certificate of employment, contract, or in our cases, we are a freelancers, a certificate of registrations from BIR. So we delved deeper into the Digital Nomad Visa, and initially, we wanted to apply for this type of visa for Czech Republic. We don't know why. It just came to our mind because it has a lower cost of living compared to other European countries. Portugal is not in the picture at all. Along the way, we found out that there's no digital nomad visa in Czech Republic, not available at all. So we check other countries in Europe that offer a digital nomad visa. There are quite a few, but the deal breaker for us in choosing a country are, number one, it could offer the fastest permanent residency or citizenship, low income requirements or proof of income within Schengen territory, and low cost of living. While researching the digital nomad visa, our attention shifted to Portugal and Spain. And later on, we decided to go for Portugal. So keep in mind that at this point, we're still on digital nomad visa and not the job seeker visa. We thoroughly searched for information, check articles, vlogs. Unfortunately, I never saw any Filipinos applying for this type of visa, which made us anxious. I mean, we need a guide, right? It would increase our approval rate if we saw how someone did it in the past. All the requirements seems good by the book, except for the income requirement. We need to provide proof that we are receiving 3,040 euro per month as an income and it has to reflect in our bank account. We reach a dead end here. It's not going to work for us at all because as a freelancers, our income is not stable. Sometimes, yes, we do get 3,000 euro a month, but sometimes no. So we revisited Spain's digital nomad visa again, but it's not really doable for us. I'm going to tell you later why. It's either Portugal or Portugal. That's it. And then after a few weeks, a reel flashed on my Facebook account about a job seeker visa, but not in Portugal. So we found out that there are six countries in Europe offering a job seeker visa. They are Austria, Denmark, Germany, Portugal, Spain, and Sweden. Among these countries, only Portugal and Spain are doable for us. Other countries have certain requirements such as needing to be in a specific profession category like IT and healthcare to qualify for their job seeker visa. We conducted a comparison between Portugal and Spain based on our main goal, which is to secure a job and obtain a residency or citizenship. And here it is. As a recruiter, I checked the job market in Portugal and Spain, and I found out through job posting that Portugal is more in the lookout for English-speaking recruiters and accountants, while in Spain, they always specify or mention in their job posting must speak Spanish. Portugal is also becoming a startup hub, which means there will be a lot of opportunities coming from foreign investors, meaning more investors, more opportunities. According to my research as well, Portuguese people can speak at least basic English to foreigners. It's never been a problem. Portugal or Portuguese people are more friendly to foreigners than Spanish. And the cost of living in Portugal, of course, is lower compared to Spain. However, as a recruiter, I know that it means salaries are lower too. Portugal is underrated for Filipinos. Actually, according to the 2021 census, there are only 3,400 plus Filipinos in Portugal. The lower number of Filipinos means a higher chance of getting noticed by a potential employers. Portugal is in the top 10 safest country in the world, which is actually very surprising when I'm doing my research. Please note that all I mentioned here is based on our research from articles and vlogs. I will be updating in my succeeding videos if our reality in Portugal met our expectations. Now, let's dive into the Portugal Job Seeker Visa. And what I'm going to share with you is based on our personal experience while processing this visa. I was in touch with the Embassy of Portugal in Jakarta since July 2023, exchanging emails for inquiries, clarifications. Thankfully, they are very responsive. Keep in mind that the requirements may be different for each individual, profession, and nationality. I'll discuss with you the overview of the requirements and the application process. So I am a recruiter, my friend is an accountant. So if your profession falls under administrative, non-technical, non-licensed, this video might be for you. The job seeker visa is granted for a period of 120 days, renewable for another 60 days, and allows only one entry into Portugal. The holder of this visa will be allowed to look for a job and can perform a job until the visa expires or until the residence permit is granted. The downside of this type of visa is that it is only a single entry and valid only in Portugal and cannot be used to enter other European countries, meaning once your visa expires, you must go back to your country or point of origin if you didn't secure a job. These are the requirements for the job seeker visa sourced from the website of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, Portugal. As you can see, the requirements are vague and general. They do not specify any profession or nationality. Anyone can apply literally. However, from our side, we submitted additional documents that would increase our chances of visa approval. What we did was create a requirements checklist to guide us in completing our documentation. We used the list from the Ministry of Foreign Affairs and also included additional requirements that could increase our chances of visa approval. And here it is in the page 2. So you may take a screenshot if you want. This is the first page, and this is the second page. As you can see, here are the additional requirements that we submitted. We'll divide this discussion of the requirements into 3 parts. The first part will be the general documentation. The second part is the specific documents, and the third part is the additional requirements. Now let's go through it. The first part, which is the general documentation. All right. This is the national visa application form, and this form is used for visa application related to residence and temporary stay. You can find the official link to this form in the description of this video. Keep in mind that before you fill in this form, you must already secure your round-trip ticket booking and accommodation booking. The dates of your accommodation, ticket, and stay in Portugal must match altogether. Otherwise, you may compromise your application and it could lead to denial of the visa. We'll have to send our original passport and a copy of this one. Picture, you will need to submit two passport size picture as per Schengen requirements, and they must be 45 mm in height and 35 mm in width. One will be attached to the application form and one separated. Criminal record inquiry is essentially an authorization letter in which we authorize them to conduct a criminal background check on us. The authorization is written in Portuguese. You can copy and paste it in Google Translate to guide you in filling this out. Or you can take a screenshot of this video to see how we filled it in. Next is the criminal record certificate. Basically, this is the NBI clearance, and this document must be apostilled. A valid travel insurance. The travel insurance must match your travel date as well, and it must be compliant with Schengen regulations. The travel insurance must cover accidental, corpse repatriation, medical, emergency services, and COVID. When you purchase travel insurance, you will receive three documents: COVID certificate, policy schedule, and travel policy summary of schedule. You only have to attach the COVID certificate and policy schedule to your application. The amount of the travel insurance depends on the number of days of travels and the package you'll select. We purchase our travel insurance from AXA and we got a 20% discount. And I will be creating a separate video about that, how we got that 20% discount. We paid 25,490.59 for two persons for 119 days, including the travel date. The copy of the return transport title is basically the ticket, and you must attach the round trip confirmed ticket to your application. When we say confirmed ticket, it means you have already purchased the ticket. So since August 2023, we have been tracking flights from Manila to Lisbon so we could book the cheaper one. And in October, we booked our ticket even though we were planning to apply for the visa in December. Proof of financial resources is what we call show money. The show money required for this visa is 3 times the minimum wage of Portugal. As of January 2024, the minimum wage in Portugal is 820 euro. So the show money would be 2,460 euro. If you have more than that, then it's good. You can provide a bank certificate and a statement of account as a proof of financial resources. The bank certificate, remember, must be addressed to the Embassy of Portugal in Jakarta, as you can see in the screenshot. The statement of account must cover 6 months. Each bank has a different format for the bank certificate and statement of account. It's better to consult your bank or inform them that you'll be using it to apply for a visa in Portugal. If you have a credit card, this could also be an additional financial resources, but this will not replace the cash, meaning a credit card alone will not be accepted as a proof of financial resources. Proof of financial resources is not needed if there is a Portuguese or resident who will cover all your expenses, but that requires some kind of a letter of guarantee. Let's proceed to the second part of the requirements, which is the specific documents. There are only two requirements for specific documents. One is the declaration with indication of the condition for the estimated stay in Portugal. As you can see, I do not have a check mark on these requirements because this document is to be filed in SEF within 3 days from the arrival date in Portugal. Here's the screenshots that say so, and I provided the link from SEF to make sure that all information I provided in this video is from a legitimate source. The next specific document required is the proof of presentation of a declaration of expression of interest for enrollment in the IEFP. It could be in English, Portuguese, French, or Spanish. And this is how it looks like. I'm going to make a separate video on how to obtain this document and what is it for. Let's proceed to the third part of the requirements, which is the additional requirements or additional documents. We added these documents to our application to increase the chances of getting approved for the visa. In this part, you could include any documents that, you know, that you have to, so you could have a higher chances of the visa approval. We advise you to process the apostille education and work experience at an early stage of completing your requirements. For education, if you have a bachelor degree, you'll have to go to your university, CHED, and DFA. And each of these three entities has its own timelines for processing and releasing. Similarly, for the work experience certificate or employment certificate, you'll have to go to a lawyer, execute an affidavit, then go to RTC, and finally to DFA. They also have their own timelines. I have not been working full-time since 2021, so I am attaching a freelancer certificate just to let the embassy know that even though I am not working full-time, I still exercise my profession in some ways. For Tina, she attached her individual contractor certificate that is similar to freelancer certificate. We advise married women to include the apostilled marriage certificate in their visa application, especially if they have documents with both single and married names. This will serve as proof that you are the same person, right? And again, process the apostilled marriage certificate ahead of time as you need to go to PSA first, then to DFA. Although it's not in the requirements to provide a proof of accommodation, if you'll go back to the national visa application form, you'll need to write an address where you're going to stay in Portugal. And if you are not sponsored by anyone, logically, you need to book one in order to complete the visa application form. Also, we all know that it's a must in all visa applications to indicate where are you going to stay in that country, right? We obtained this 8-page detailed lease contract through Flatshow. When I downloaded it, it's not mentioned as draft. I just put it to let the embassy know that we are planning to stay in this accommodation and I am in touch with the landlord regarding our intended stay. Booking in Flatshow is kind of tricky because it will allow only one name to reflect in the contract, and I need Tina's name to be there as well because this is part of the requirements. I'm going to create a separate video on how we pull this off without spending a single cent, because if you book to other booking platforms like Airbnb, they will require you to pay a certain amount sometimes, or in uni places you need to pay a deposit. So in this part of the accommodation booking, what we need is only a proof to attach in our visa requirement without spending a single cent. Lastly, but the most important, is the payment for the visa in courier fee to send our passport back in the Philippines. The visa fee is 90 euro per applicant, and the courier fee is 900 Indonesian rupees if you are residing outside Manila. and 400,000 rupees if you are residing within Manila area. All you need to send and you need to send the payment to the embassy in Portugal in Jakarta. But before you send the payment, please communicate first to the embassy and reconfirm the information and the details. They will provide you some payment instructions. We encountered a lot of challenges sending our payment. I went to four banks and two remittance centers, but to no avail. That is why I'll be doing a separate video as well about that, how we did pay this from our side. After the payment, send all your documents to Embassy of Portugal in Jakarta, including your original passport and the payment receipt. This is how our documents look. There is a checklist at the front and securely bound. On the front of the envelope, we put a note to send back all apostille documents after their evaluation. In our early communication with the embassy officer, they said that they could return all the original documents if we wish to, like the apostilled one, because we need that when we apply and secure a job in Portugal. And at the back of the envelope, we put the type of visa that we will be applying for and the return address. After we send our documents via courier, I send an email to the Embassy of Portugal with a tracking number, scanned copy of our documents, and the receipt of the visa fee and courier fee. The processing time of the visa is 30 to 60 days. Yes, that long. So better to really plan and prepare your application ahead. This is where my video ends. I hope this video provided insights into what you are looking for about the job seeker visa in Portugal. All the relevant links from legitimate sources are in the description of this video. I will be creating some follow-up videos about the other requirements as well. If you have any questions, I'm reachable on my recruitment Facebook page, Be Hired by Angeline Rugel. You can find it in the description on this channel. So, see you in Portugal!